just had to go meet with Felix. We were making some shoeing adjustments on some babies. And back now, we're going to run through Kevin's list. Kevin's horses. So it was great to have Stonebridge Hall is going to be racing this week. Trained great the middle of the week. Kevin's taken his time with him, done it right. His leg's been cleared by the vet 4 times now in the last 2 months. Should be good to go now. Going to start racing next week. What about Road Tripper? My goodness gracious. Road Tripper. I've said it and said it and said it. This is a talented colt. He's a good horse. And we just kept working and working and working on him. And Kevin and the guys have done a great job with this colt. I got away 10th because I was sick of qualifying him. Got away 10th at Woodbine. Sat 10th. 4th beat a length. Another 2 steps, he's a winner. I kicked the earplugs down the lane. I think he wins, but he might have run, so I just left him alone. I didn't want to poke the bear, so to speak. So he comes the last quarter in 27 and a piece, last half 56 seconds. Jesus, this colt has got some speed. He's going to be a good horse. So Road Tripper was very, very good. Book the Bet is in to go tonight. Saturday night, Book the Bet and Delmar J are in the finals. Again, I don't know what I'm going to do yet tonight. I'm not feeling the greatest. And as I said, there's lots of good drivers down there. I might not make it down tonight. So you'll know by the time you see this video who drove Book the Bet and Delmar J. If it was me, I hope we win. If it wasn't me, I hope they win. So so it should be a good night tonight in London. Delmar J is racing. He made the final of the City of London. Outside post, tough field. Just be great to get money with both these horses on the outside. So Book the Bet and Delmar J are both racing there tonight. Dancing at Midland, got some great news with Dancing at Midland. He came up a little lame there 2 weeks ago, and we were worried. The vet thought that he might have had a line in his cannon bone. Kevin did the right thing, didn't train him, pulled him up, brought him back to the burn. He had knuckled over warming up for his training mile, and had knuckled over warming up for his training mile. The vet thought that there might be something there. We gave him 10 days in the stall, re-x-rayed, clean slate. Nothing there. It was just a shadow, as they say. I'm not a vet. I'm not a radiologist. I don't know what the hell a shadow is, but apparently it looks a lot like a crack until it's not a crack. So great news with him. He'll be racing next week. Bex Pride re-qualified in 58. Actually looked good. I don't know where we're going to race him. I know Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, there's no B-track racing as Grand River and Georgian Downs open up soon. I would imagine his next start will be at Grand River, I would assume, but we'll see. Facing Justice. Oh, the plague is finally over. We claimed this horse, and he raced poorly his first start. We were looking at making some changes. He came up lame. He ended up with an abscess in his left front, right front foot. I think right front foot. Anyway, couldn't walk for 10 days to 2 weeks. Couldn't walk. And, you know, our clients are like, geez, you know, when's this horse going to race? And I get that. But our job is to make sure, Kevin's job is to make sure he gets sound. And my job is to help him do that if I can and talk to you about it. And, yeah, he was lame for 2-3 weeks. And sound now. He's trained twice. I believe Kevin said he wanted to school him on Monday. I don't think he said Friday. I think he said Monday. We're going to school him on Monday at Mohawk. Like to go mile and 2-1 with him and then get him right in to go next weekend. So your horse, Facing Justice, for the clients out that own him, he will be back next weekend. Really appreciate your patience with the horse and patience with us. That's a great thing about the stable, man, is that I've been doing this a long time and worked for a lot of people. Before I trained horses, worked for a lot of people that did it also. And owners sometimes, without meaning to, can put a lot of pressure on an already volatile situation when you have the trainers that are really trying to do what's right for the horse and trying to get the horse back to 100%. And then you got the clients who are just asking questions, you know, when is he going to be ready? What's wrong with him? And it creates a real stressful situation. And that's the one thing about you guys. And I always say our clients are the best, and people say, oh, you are. And the reason they are is because when we have fractional ownership the way we do, and these ownership groups are built in such a way where a lot of people own small shares, it really reduces the financial burden on them and the financial pressure on them, and in turn diffuses what could be an extremely stressful situation. So very, very lucky to have the clients we do and the people that I'm facing justice. Thank you very much for your patience. Your health, your horse will be ready to race next weekend. Master Saver, a little bit flat in the City of London. Master Saver's an okay horse. Now he's not making breaks. He's wanting to do his work. Is he talented? He's okay. I'm not going to name any stake races after Master Saver. He tries hard, and I'd like to see him continue to make checks. And at a point when the classification gets a little difficult for him, I think we're going to have a discussion of where we what we do with him and if we sell him. I mean, there's still equity in the horse, not what we have into him just yet, but he's still worth money. He's sound. He's a beautiful horse. He trots really nice. And I'm sure he'll progress at some rate and be a better horse. But what that rate is will be up to him. Looking at it from the outside, I don't see the progression I would like to see. If I owned him, I wouldn't be thrilled, which I do own him. I own over half of him. But, you know, we've given this horse a lot of opportunity to become a good horse. Just not there yet. He's not a sour horse. He's not a bad horse. He's just not a great horse. So Master Saver, hopefully he's going to continue to pick up checks. Like to see him in the winner's circle at some point. And, you know, get a picture taken with the big fella. Paleline Blue Chip, she's been on a roll, racing really, really well. Hasn't missed the board, I don't think, in 7 or 8 starts. Won her last 2. And she's the little filly that got me my 3,000th lifetime win. So she, her and I will always be cemented in one way or another in history. Really happy I got it done with her. I was going to get it done with Road Tripper the week before. So either way, I own a significant piece of both those horses. I have a lot of respect for both those horses, as they both are overachievers and they've overcome some adversity. So really happy I could get my 3,000th win with Pay the Line Blue Chip. She's in to go tomorrow night in a straight condition race. I'd love to see her win in there. So that's Pay the Line Blue Chip. Stonebridge Hall, we talked about him. He'll be ready to go, I think, Thursday or Friday of next week. Tortola Sunrise, missed getting in, as did Rose Run Speedster this week. He'll race Thursday somewhere, either the Claimer at Mohawk or some sort of a condition claiming event or condition event at Flamborough. Thursday will be the starting point for Tortola Sunrise, I believe. And Art Seeker, a little flat, both his last 2 starts. Unimpressive last week at Flamborough. I got run into a little bit at the half. Horse made a break in front of me, but need to show a little more desire. Kevin thought that he maybe trained him too hard in between and he was a little flat because of that. Usually when you train horses hard, when you have them on a regimen of training hard, they respond positively to that. This horse, with the heat and everything else, maybe he doesn't want to be trained hard in between starts. So I think Kevin's just going to jog him all week and see how he races off a steady diet of jogging this week without any training in between. Lots of horses do that. Just a matter of finding the proper training schedule and training regimen for each horse, and I think Kevin's probably in the right direction with this guy. We'll see how he does next week. So we got Jason's Crew. He won with Mystical Mission. Sally DeVee just got picked off the wire. Really real Willy race, great. Peregrine Blue Chip's on the cusp of being ready to go. Fan the Flames was fantastic. American League, Boston Glide, Buckeye Babe. All these horses seem good, so Jason had a good week and good things going forward. Kevin, who did we win with Kevin? Paleline Blue Chip won. Road Tripper just got beat. Booked a bet, Del Mar J Racing and Stake Races tonight. Facing just, Happy Holidays. Oh my goodness, I forgot about Happy Holidays. Finished 3rd the other night, first start out of a long layoff. Looks great, put some weight on, looks shiny, raced great. Off the pace, closing hard from 3rd. Expecting great things from the big filly that holds the track record at Flamborough nonetheless for age trotting mares. And I haven't had anybody prove me right or wrong yet, for those of you out there. I believe, personally, the all-age Canadian, not all-age, the aged trotting mare record holder in Canada on a half-mile track, I believe is Happy Holidays of all time in Canada. I said it. I want you to prove me wrong. Happy Holidays, 154-4 last year at Flamborough, I believe is the fastest mile of it by a trotting mare in Canada on a half-mile track all time. Damn, I should ask Paul McDonnell or Anthony Hahn. I guarantee you they'd know. Anyway, no big deal. I'd love somebody to actually prove me right or wrong on that. So, we got those horses facing justice, ready to rock. Stonebridge Hall, ready to rock. Kevin Stable looks good moving forward. All systems go for both stables. Really, really happy with what I've seen. We're now getting the babies ready to go. We schooled 40 this week. We'll have almost 50 ready to go in 3 weeks, 4 weeks at the most. Andrew Harris will be getting some. Angie Coleman will be getting some. I've made a decision on Bay Jewel myself. I believe I'm sending Bay Jewel to Jim Orridge. Very, very good guy. Good horseman. He's getting her for sure. Swandre the Giant, I've been told, is going to Brandon Bates. Good luck with him, Mr. Bates. He's a very, very nice colt. He'll be ready to go in a few weeks. And then the Guccio colt, Mr. Caper, when his foot's better, he'll be going somewhere. Haven't made my mind up yet. And I haven't made my mind up with Stonebridge Loyal yet. But they'll be heading to Indiana. So we're going to get into the top five, top 10, and run through all the babies in an event-packed week for thestable.ca. Back soon.